What's up everybody, Tech Guy Charlie here, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you 5 amazing deep customization apps for your Samsung Galaxy smartphone. And trust me, you guys are gonna absolutely love these apps. And guys, as always, if you enjoy watching these kind of videos, do subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Alright, let's begin. You might have seen from the intro part of this video that I was able to change the colors in the drop-down notification panel. And as you can see, the colors in the drop-down notification panel matches my wallpaper. So this is possible because there's an app available in the Galaxy Store called Theme Park. And this app has been developed by Good Lock Labs. So Theme Park really lets you customize your phone. You can create your very own custom themes, customize the Samsung keyboard, change the colors in the quick panel and the volume control panel that appears whenever you press this button. Now we're not gonna deep dive into the application, then this video will become super long, but still, let me give you a quick demonstration of how to customize the colors in the quick panel. Okay, so inside the Theme Park application, select quick panel and then tap on create new. And this will give you a preview of how your drop-down notification panel will look like. Right, so the first thing you have to do is pick a base color by tapping over here. You can also change the saturation from here, tap on OK. So that will pick a base color. Now to change the individual colors, you'll need to tap on these circles and select a different color for all of these. Now you see this little blue dot over here? That corresponds to this big circle. That means if you tap on this circle, that will change the color of the notification over here. So let's do this. Tap over here. And let's select a saturation for the notification. Let us select this color, tap on OK. And as you can see, that picks a color for the notifications. This blue dot points to the background of the drop-down notification panel. So if I tap over here, you will be able to pick a color for the background of the drop-down notification panel. Let's pick a lighter color. So there you go. By the way, you will have to change the colors in both dark mode as well as the light mode. So right now it's in dark mode. If I tap over here, it will change to light mode. So again, you will have to customize all the colors and change them manually. But to keep the video short, we will only change it for the dark mode. Right, so we have changed the colors. We will press on the save button and give the theme a name. Let's give it a name, green. Okay. And now if I select this, that should change the color of our drop-down notification panel. So as you can see, the colors in the drop-down notification panel have changed. So I think these sort of colors will look really nice if we had this kind of a wallpaper. By the way, I always put my wallpaper links in the video description, so do check them out. So with this kind of a wallpaper, this color in the drop-down notification panel looks fantastic. Awesome, right? So you can really go to town customizing your phone using Theme Park. I've just shown a small portion of this. You can also create your very own theme, change the color of the keyboard and the volume panel. So Theme Park is an awesome application. It's available in the Galaxy Store. Make sure to download it and customize your very own Samsung Galaxy smartphone. Now guys, if you are using a Samsung Galaxy Note series phone, then you should download an app called Pentastic. Pentastic lets you customize the S Pen functionality of your Galaxy Note phone, such as the sound that plays back when you remove the S Pen, the looks of the Air Command menu, and even the pointer of the S Pen. And this app is also available in the Galaxy Store, and it's called Pentastic by Good Lock Labs. So like I said, the Pentastic application lets you customize the S Pen aspects of your Galaxy Note phone. You can change the way the Air Command looks. You have different styles here. I really like this old retro style of the Air Command menu. Looks really nice. Then you can also select a different pointer. As you can see, I have selected the heart pointer. So as I hover the S Pen over the screen, you can see that little heart. You can also change the sound that plays back whenever you remove and reinsert the S Pen. Lastly, you can also choose what happens if you press the button and double tap the S Pen on the screen. So this app, Pentastic, is awesome. It really lets you customize the S Pen aspect of your Galaxy Note device. If you have a Samsung Galaxy smartphone, then most likely you've used the edge panels. Now, one thing that I really love about edge panels is that you can use them even without unlocking your phone. So even while the phone is locked, you can pull the edge panels out and you can use them. Now, you can add some super useful edge panels to this, such as the calculator edge panel, the calendar edge panel, and my favorite, the direct call edge panel. Now, this particular edge panel direct call will let you make a phone call even without unlocking your phone. So you can have some favorite contacts over here, and once you tap on their name, the phone will dial the number. And this is without unlocking your phone. How awesome is that? And same goes for these edge panels, especially the calculator panel. This makes opening up the calculator very easy. You can just double tap the screen, open the calculator edge panel, and do stuff over here. You don't need to unlock the phone. Look for the calculator app in the app drawer. Just open up the edge panel up and calculator is right over there. Same goes for calendar and my personal favorite, direct call. And all of these edge panels that I showed you are free. This one is called direct call panel. This one is calculator panel. And finally, the calendar panel. So I think you should download these three edge panels from the Galaxy Store because they are absolutely amazing. Another application that I think everyone should download is Sound Assistant. And I got this from the Galaxy Store. This app has been developed by Good Lock Labs. Alright, so Sound Assistant will let you customize various aspects related to sound on your Galaxy device. Plus, you can also customize the volume panel. You can add some additional features over here. Let me show you a couple of my favorite features of the Sound Assistant application, starting from the volume panel customization. Alright, so first off, you can change the layout of the volume panel. You can have it to the left or to the right. Next, you can also touch and drag the volume panel, so you can have it appear on the top like this. Now, I personally prefer the bottom right hand side because then it's easier for my thumb to reach the volume panel. You can also enable show volume level, so now the volume panel will display the volume level right over here. Next, moving on to the expanded panel view, you have the option of enabling the toolbar function, so that adds an extra toolbar at the bottom like this. So check this out guys, because we have enabled the extra toolbar, let's expand the volume panel, and now if you press on this button, that will take you to the equalizer setting. So you no longer have to go to sound setting to access your EQ. And I also think that you should enable app volume. So this feature allows you to individually control the volume level of apps that are on your phone. Very useful for controlling the music player volume while you are gaming. So as you can see, while gaming, I can adjust my music volume without actually disturbing the sound of the game. How awesome is that? Now, we're not gonna deep dive into the Sound Assistant application, otherwise this video will become 20 minutes long. But another feature that I absolutely love is control music with volume keys. So this feature lets you go back and forward in your playlist by long pressing the volume keys. Let me quickly demonstrate. So for this to work, your screen needs to be off. So if I long press the volume down key, that skips to the next song. If I press and hold the volume up key, that will go back to the previous song. So awesome little feature. This is why I recommend that everyone should have the Sound Assistant application on their Galaxy smartphones. Again, I'm not gonna go through all of these settings. They are pretty much self-explanatory. But yeah, this is an awesome addition to your Samsung Galaxy smartphone. If you guys are using the navigation gestures, or better known as swipe gestures, may I suggest you to install an app called One Hand Operation Plus, because this app really lets you customize what you can do with the navigation gestures. So check this out guys, I can actually swipe down like this and that opens up the quick panel. Over here I can change the brightness, control the music player volume, and we have some quick toggle icons. If I swipe up, that opens up recents. If I swipe once, that goes back to the previous screen. But if I swipe and hold, that will take me back to the home screen. If I swipe to the bottom and hold, that will drop down the notification panel. And lastly, if I swipe up and hold, that will take a screenshot. Awesome, right? So this is possible because of the One Hand Operation Plus app. So this app adds a ton of features to the navigation gestures. So let me actually show you what I've done. I've gone into right handle because this is how I usually use my phone. My right hand thumb usually rests on the right handle. So over here, I have gone into diagonally down and selected quick tools. So that will open up the quick tools. Then I have also changed diagonal up and I have selected recent key. So if I swipe up like this, that opens up recents. Then I have also enabled long swipe, and for straight left, I have selected the home key. So straight left, that takes me back home. Diagonal up takes a screenshot. And finally, diagonal down opens up the notification panel. So that is what the long swipe does. Then you also have some advanced settings. You can change the animation. I have selected the arrow 2 animation, but I think the curved line will be the default animation. I prefer the arrow 2. I've also disabled fit to keyboard option. Otherwise, the navigation gestures do not work at the edges of the keyboard. So yes, this is the One Hand Operation Plus app. If you guys are using the navigation gestures on Android, I suggest that you install this because this adds a ton of features to the navigation gestures. So guys, with that said, we are almost at the end of this video. Now before I go, let me show you a bonus live wallpaper app. So this live wallpaper is called Double Helix, and this looks absolutely amazing. So check this out. Looks absolutely gorgeous. And if you use theme park and properly customize your phone, you can have the colors in the quick panel match the live wallpaper. And as you can see, that looks absolutely gorgeous. Now, this being a free live wallpaper, most of the settings here are disabled, including the ability to change the color. But if you really like this wallpaper, you can buy the full version. It's not that expensive, and I do have the full version on here. And once you change the colors and customize some of these settings, this live wallpaper looks absolutely stunning. So check this out. Double Helix in red looks absolutely beautiful. I mean, take a look at that. Looks gorgeous. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you've enjoyed, make sure to leave a thumbs up and follow me on my social media accounts. I'll put all the links in the video description. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.